Hi there! Today is Mother's Day from where I stay, so happy Mother's Day to all you mothers out there, and please continue to make more babies so that we can have more Marvel Heroes fans, alright? So, well, that aside, today is about Punisher. Friends of mine probably know that I've been struggling with this video for a long time because Punisher is actually one of the most complex heroes I've ever played in this game. All right, and I've spent a lot of time trying to understand the two builds that he has. He has two builds, the Ol'Painless as well as the Flamethrower. All right, I've been spending a lot of recon devices, mathematics behind it, as well as on the training room as well, to try to rationalize certain behavior that is totally not intuitive, but it's working in a certain way. All right, so now Punisher, for those who may not know him. He's probably one of the highest DPS hero in this game, but that is with a footnote, all right? So in a very controlled environment, like in a training room, or even in raid, all right? His damage is ridiculous, all right? His damage output is ridiculous. But outside training room, it could be a different story, all right? So I'm going to talk a little bit about what are the conditions to make Punisher's damage really high. And I probably think that that is also one of the reasons why they tune it so high. Now, those who have been following the development of Punisher are probably aware that Art of War, which is the one of the Gazillion's ex-employer who has done the review of this one, I think it's a masterpiece. It's his last masterpiece before leaving the team. So I really, really had a lot of fun with Punisher. The entire Punisher gameplay revolve around something called reload. So, you know, this is the ammo that you have. And as you deplete your ammo, you can do reload, all right? And reload will, you know, get everything back to 100%, like, you know, all the first person suit that you play. But reload work in a very peculiar way, in a sense that if you reload too early, there's a penalty there, all right? So the cooldown for reload, if you are reloading at a high ammo available, you are actually taking like a 20 second of cooldown. However, if your reload is actually down to say 75%, which is a low ammo, your cooldown actually is 15 seconds. All right, so that's one concept very important. And when you reload, two things happens. All right, the first thing is that at low ammo, which is you see the thing goes in red, at low ammo you are gaining close to 800 damage rating for 8 seconds. All right, so that is pretty massive. I mean, you know, you try to get 800 damage rating somewhere in the gear, you know, it's kind of hard to get those numbers. All right, so that's the first thing that happened if you manage to get the low ammo. And then the second thing that happened is that if you're having the whole 9-yard unique, your next 15 range attack actually gain a pretty decent crit hit and brutal strike rating. All right, now how do you trigger that? If you observe the buff window, I mean, I think Punisher is a little bit bugged right now, but if you just observe the buff window, once I get into red zone, which is the reload zone, the red one right now, if I reload, two things happen. Well, it doesn't show the other one, the whole 9-yard, but you see this counting down, and this one is your damage buff. And when this one becomes zero, you got no buff there. All right, so so that is one thing that you should be aware. So within 15 seconds of this reload window, 8 seconds being buffed up very nicely. Now, you could potentially shorten this whole entire reload cycle, and that's where the excitement comes in this game, because it is the first time in this game whereby cost reduction gear means something. Because in order to shorten this duration of reload, you equip cost reduction gear, like for instance the Magneto Medallion give you 21% ammo power ammo cost reduction. Your strength, for instance, give you another, say, 1% per rank to your ammo reduction. Loki synergy give you another 5%. So all in all, I'm achieving a 43.3% cooldown reduction on top of either 15 or 20 seconds I'm doing, all right? So, but to explain this one, to paint the scenario why gearing for reload is very, very interesting, I have drawn out some graph to explain, because it's a lot easier to go into the kind of a graph, all right? So if you look at the whole reload, just to recap, right, the reload cooldown is 20 seconds, alright, 20 seconds to reload the entire. But if you use it at the low ammo, when the ammo turns red, which is dropped below 25%, it is a 15 second reload, alright. So the buff window is 8 seconds. So you can see that there are two buffs, like I mentioned. It is 20% damage, alright, on the normal damage that you have. Resulting in an overall 4.4% for me, because you know you have to take into consideration of the existing gear, existing crit and damage rating, and I've got another video on damage explained, but 4.4% overall average damage is remarkable. Alright, I mean, just to have the buff kept up. Alright, and then the second buff, like I mentioned, next 15 range attack, you get a certain crit. Now, for Punisher, the crit and the brutal is already very much eating into the diminishing return. But having said that, you know, it's always good to buff it up. You know, however, I think it's about 4% ish for the crit and brutal, maybe a bit higher. But that is around the kind of range we are talking about here. All right, so in order to get the best out of Punisher, you have got to shorten the window there, alright? So there are a couple of things you need to do. The first thing you need to do is shorten the window. Now, what do I mean by shortening the reload window? So for me, if I have 43.3% cost reduction gear, alright, the maximum is the 50% you can get, you can shorten it up to 8.5 second reload. So every 8.5 second, you can reload your ammo, alright? And then by shortening that to 8.5 second, it means that, you know, you are getting the 8 second buff all the time, right? You see what I'm trying to say, right? So if you shorten your reload, you are actually guaranteed a damage rating of that percentage, you know, throughout the cycle, close enough. But that's only part of the story. It will not work if you consume ammo faster than you should, or you actually take too long to consume your ammo, all right? So there are three scenarios out there. The first scenario is you have not enough ammo. So, you know, although your reload time is 8.5 seconds, 8 second buff, but your ammo lasts much less than 8 seconds, all right? So what happens is that you do something, you know, you try to kill a mob, and after that, you got no action because you run out of ammo. There's nothing you can do, right? It's just no action there. So what is the result? A DPS loss. But fortunate for Punisher, if you equip all his unique and so on, this scenario shouldn't happen. And also, depends on what kind of power you use as well. So that make it really interesting, right? Scenario two, you have too much ammo. So what does that mean is that, you have to, in order to get a buff, you have to get your ammo to below 25%, all right? It means that your ammo lasts much longer than 8 seconds, all right? So for the 8 seconds, you're buffed. But beyond the 8 seconds, you're not buffed at all, right? And that is the reason why powers like Ol'Painless, like the Flamethrower, that will channel for 4 seconds or so without consuming any ammo, is a DPS loss, right? I've done it in the training room. I'll explain it a little bit later, right? Because all this channel power, you are not consuming ammo and your cycle becomes longer, but there are remedy around it as well, all right? So I'll talk a little bit about that later. But the take home message is that things like submachine gun, for instance, they are the highest DPS power, but if you use that, guess what? Because it consumes much lesser ammo, it also lasts much longer than 8 seconds, all right? So you lose a buff and net, you are losing a lot. So what is the optimal condition is that you have to find your sweet spot, all right? You have to reduce your reload time to the 8 second buff, and your ammo must last roughly around 8 seconds, all right? And that is a very sweet spot whereby you're close to optimal, all right? Anything else that increase your ammo, like your your costume core that is on the 25% spirit and ammo or health recovery, those are bad things because you don't want your ammo suddenly get increased on your cycle, right? So going back to the game, so what it really means is this, right? So I want to show you one rotation so you understand. I'm using an Ol'Painless build. Interestingly, I can't use Ol'Painless because it is, to me, I've run through a cycle, a rotation, it is actually a DPS loss. So what I use is the pineapple Granite. I have to use that because the vulnerability debuff as well as the only DOT for Ol'Painless build. All right, I use Headshot as well. Now Headshot itself is not that great, but you know it has an execute function to it, and it's good to mix the one that has a cooldown power to it, because cooldown works something like a DOT, a damage over time. It's just that you get the damage up front, although it's not as much and also not as efficient. But that's fine. We are not looking for ammo efficiency here, all right? And this is the only two I use. And then after that, I have to reload. Now, pay attention as I run through the thing. Pay attention to my buff here, because I want to show you the sweet spot whereby as the buff disappear, I can actually do reload, right? So it goes something like this, right? So I do like pineapple, headshot, then I burn this one, right? So I burn it to 75% first, right? Then I reload, then 1, 2, then I just keep burning. Now you see my thing is 4 seconds, 3 seconds, 2 seconds. My reload time is up, just nice, right? I get just enough ammo to last for my next reload. And that is the thing I'm talking about here, right? So it just nice, when it comes to zero, just nice, right? So that is the beauty of the whole thing, because you want to have this whole 9 yard as well as the power increase buff constantly, all the time, all right? If you try to mix anything else, like the Ol'Painless, you are actually losing DPS in terms of, because you are not you know, getting the full buff, because you have lengthened the whole entire rotation window. You are not fitting within the 8 second time window, 8.5 second time window that I have, right? So that is very important. The second thing that you need to notice is that when should you do your signature, right? So your signature should ideally be executed when you have the buff on. So always when you have the, so for instance, you have all these two things going on, then after that, when you hit the red zone, when you reload, then I will do a signature there, and I will start to use the other one as well. All right. So if you look at the time set at 1 second, right? So I have to make sure that this is constantly on all the time. So that is the Ol'Painless build. Now I want to show you the other build as well, which is the Flamethrower. All right. Flamethrower is work in a different way. Okay, let me just show it to you. All right. So for Flamethrower, Flamethrower has two DPS, two damage over time. One is the pineapple granite. Another one is the this one is the blast also give you the damage over time. Then you have the poison as well, also damage over time. So you have three damage over time layer. Alright, and then the interesting thing is that some of these cause a bleed. Okay, so some of that, the blast cause a bleed, the nerve gas cause poison. Alright, so you have a bleed here, you have poison here, and this one will give you a burn. But you have to understand that once you use the flamethrower, you actually lose the damage over time. So the very good thing about this design is that everything is 8 seconds. Alright, so it's around 8 seconds, 7 seconds, 6 seconds. So, you know, it's kind of like, you know, when to reapply the 6 second ones. So use it as a benchmark when to start to reapply things. And what I do is that I will actually apply the flamethrower and at the tail end of the nerf gas, expiry, because you wouldn't want to cause explosion too much, too early, and lose your damage over time. So, you know, in a nutshell, something like, you know, I 1, 2, 3, right? Then after that, I wait until it drops to 4, 3, 2, then I'll explode everything, and then I reapply the thing, right? So that is how you usually play it. And the good thing about it is that once the target is being poisoned, bleeding, and burned, your main burst fire would be dealing more damage, all right? 30% more damage to it, all right? So the flamethrower build, it works in that way, all right? So I would not, unless there are a lot of mobs around, like in a cosmic patrol environment for a single target, if you really want to have the flamethrower build, I would not channel the whole full, like, you know, duration, because it is a, you know, if you remember what I said, right, if you don't fit into the 8.5 second reload time window in this control environment, you are losing DPS, all right? So, but when you go to the real world, like Cosmic Patrol, then you have to rethink, because the whole philosophy become different. You have to react to scenario whereby you may want to use a lot more on the flamethrower, or you may use a lot more on the Ol'Painless, all right? So I think before I take you to the real field trip, I just would like to show you my gear and the build, because I'm not sure who's going to stay on for the entire video. So I'm going to take off the gear here. So the gear that I'm using are very much a standard one that you can probably see and understand in just a bit. And by the way, Gungnir is the best legendary for rank 70, but if you're looking at the rank 80, then X is the best for Punisher. All right, so I ran through a number. I've got another video on grade 80 legendary. So for this one is the flamethrower build. All right, so for flamethrower build, the one that you have to lay the 3 damage over time, layer to it. So the 3 damage over time are the nerf gas, as well as the pineapple grenade. All right, and also the for this one, the blast. All right, so these 3 layer you have to put in. Then you know this one. Do you want to? I think if you want to use it more for the cosmic patrol, whereby you want to do a lot more area damage, I think you know this build is very nice for the cosmic patrol kind of like environment, whereby you can set many things on fire. And it looks great for your achievement as well, by the way. Then this one needs to be maxed, and the other two that I maxed is the this one, because it gives you the crit hit, brutal hit, as well as accuracy team buff. And this one, they give you kind of like nice, very nice kind of like defense to it. And that's about it for that one build. And I put 1 point in the sprint because it's quite useful to move pretty fast. Okay, for the old pain, it's very strange. Okay, this build is one of the strangest build, because I don't need that 162 points at all, because all I need in this control environment is just a headshot. Alright, I need a headshot, I need the pineapple grenade, and I need this buckshot blast, and that's all I need. Of course, I need the signature as well. Alright, so I only need this couple of them plus the 2 passive, and that's all I need. I don't need anything else. But since I'm using Ol'Painless build, then may as well put 20 on Ol'Painless. Now Ol'Painless is actually pretty alright. But the trick is that you have to aim very precisely, right? And it's a very nice burst damage in a sense, if you do it right. So you have to aim it in. I don't know whether you're aware that in Marvel Hero, to aim for the mob, you have to take the midpoint of the height of the mob and also the midpoint of the width of the mob. So like for instance, if you look at the Sentinel, the big one, right? If you aim at the foot, you actually keep running around it, and it's very precise. You have to aim it very precisely. Now, I play other games like World of Warcraft or Diablo 3. I have no problem targeting any mobs. Those games are smart enough that even if you click on the feet or somewhere near the feet on this area, they know how to detect it in a 3D manner. But I think Marvel Hero work in a very precise 2D manner, whereby if you hit somewhere here, then then you sort of like hit the whole thing. So this is The only thing about Ol'Painless is that you have to aim really, really precisely. Sometimes if you aim a bit off, then you are not hitting the boss when it moves away. So I think a lot of people don't like to use Ol'Painless. That's why I said, I don't even know why I have it. Just that just for flavor, like maybe I can use it for some burst damage out there. All right, so out there in the field. So just that's the reason why I have that. And the other thing I have is a flashbang. Now, do I need flashbang? Probably not. But I do enjoy the kind of terrified duration. Now, the bad thing is that this flashbang, I don't think it works. I don't know whether it works for boss or not. Like for instance, She-Hulk, right? She can actually do crowd control the boss. Irresistible. They would say irresistible. Like Magneto as well, it would say irresistible. So when you use it, you cannot resist. But this one can be resisted. I use it for like man, apes, those like spider on the on the waves, and it doesn't really terrify them. So. But I said, well, why not? I mean, if you are in a cosmic patrol environment whereby you can terrify them for I think 4 seconds, if I put on my gears, why not? All right. So it's more for fun only. The only thing ever I need just a couple of buttons. 1, 2, and then 3 for the main. And then after that, the signature reload. That's all. For those who do not want to put too many things out of the toolbar, it's a good news, because you could actually do away with this tool and just put Medkit there as well. So Punisher is great for those who do not enjoy hot bar dancing and just want to put everything on the one bar, right? So with that said, let's put back all my gear. Just go through a gear really quickly before I go into the actual in-game video. I mean, the great thing about the Punisher is that he look good in any gear they put in, all right? So these are very common gear, like, you know, Metasensory, the Crystal, all right? I happen to have an Omega Drive, and so why not? I mean, it's not really a high health roll, but, you know, that's fine, 447 damage. And then this one, yeah, I mean, it's pretty nice. I put it in as well. Or Hela, by the way. If you play Punisher, I think you have got to use Magneto, all right? The... because you can't recover that, you know, close to 800 damage rating, the buff that you had. Even if you lose part of it, you can't really, you know, get a damage rating higher than that. So you probably lose, all right, on DPS if you don't use anything on Magneto. The only bad thing about Magneto one, and that's why I like the Ol'Painless build rather than the other one, the Flamethrower build, is that it will actually eat into my health as I use power. So you see that just now when I run my rotation, my health actually go down pretty fast. And but the good thing about this Ol'Painless build is that the Buckshot Blast actually do it quite slowly. It's a 1.5 attack speed versus the other one, which is a much higher attack speed, I think, which is the other one. And that's why also the burst fire actually is a 2.9 per second. It hurts quite badly for the other one. So the more you hit, the more you hurt yourself, I think. Because from my experience, by the time I get down the dummy, I'm half dead. So, and also that's important for your cosmic, the costume core, to not to have that, the health gain, the extra health gain one, because you don't want extra ammo. Like I said, your ammo need to be at a sweet spot of, to me, it's about 1001, all right? So, I think this core is pretty all right. It has a life on hit, and it has the strength, which is a cost reduction as well, and it gave me some kind of health regen. But still, with Punisher, with the Magneto, it hurts so badly. Can you imagine without it? What other gear I have? So the rumor is just Blood Barrage. If you like him a lot, I think the God of Mischief will work for him pretty well. Any ring is fine. If you have Industrial City, you go for it. I don't think he need anything else. I just don't like to have anything on Spirit, so I pick a ring without it. This is the standard stat for all the pets, alright? The Insignia. Pick anything that give you crit damage rating, pick anything that give you the flat damage, alright? So, the gear wise, you can actually have, his unique is pretty nice, and you have two other options. One is the Ol'Painless, that give you buff to Ol'Painless, which I do not use Ol'Painless, so I don't use Ol'Painless, alright? So another one is the Dragon. The Dragon is more buffing the demolition and buff the heavy weapon power. So, it is alright. I mean, I prefer something more, on the firepower as well as the heavy weapon, because I for the Ol'Painless build, I do a lot. My main DPS come from the firepower, but the ammunition is also nice as well. So either way, you just have to experiment for yourself. I prefer the sword gun. All right. So with that said, the next bit of the video is take you through some simple field trip for either of the build. All right. Alright, this is Punisher Cosmic Curse in a Ol'Painless build. Alright, so basically just flashbang, terrify the mobs, and then do the pineapple kunai, and reload if you need to. Don't forget to reload. Alright, so that's about it. I pick up some health drop because you need it. Alright, so that is yet another. So terrify and pineapple, terrify, reload. Alright. So I mean he's pretty doable as well. I mean, he's been eating a lot of damage on his own like this. Alright. So the only thing about this build are twofold, right? Because I have to use a Magneto Magneto Medallion, so that is already hurting me quite badly in a real world situation. And also the I can't use a mech, a costume core that helped me with more health return, because that would defeat the whole purpose of low, the sweet spot that I talk about. So just freeze them and just pineapple them, freeze them and terrify them, pineapple them, that's about it, right? So for this case, maybe a headshot, right? Headshot will come out, get it faster. Right, just very easy, flash them, and then, you know, pineapple them, that's it. And just spam the main button that you have. Alright. So, what do we have here? Okay, let's just head to curse. Alright, reload. 1, 2, then like that. Alright, so 4 million. Yeah, that's all. Alright, so yeah, just make sure that you get the buff, and after that, do the thing that needed. I mean, that's pretty alright farming all this curse. It doesn't take too long, alright? And yeah, I mean, I just need 5 more. I mean, as you can see, it's actually pretty enjoyable playing Punisher. So I'm gonna do a flamethrower build so that you have a sense of what he's like, and also he has a spring as well that I can walk really fast without having to, you know, do the dodging. Alright, any jump occurs? No, not this time. Alright, so next one is the flamethrower build. Alright, the Punisher Cosmic Cursed flamethrower build. So it's about lay the 3 DPS damage over time layer. If it makes sense for the third one, because the third one actually require the mobs to be stationary in order to benefit from it. So, I mean, you know, ooh, double splinter. So yeah. Well, what do I have? Okay, let me demonstrate how flamethrower works. So we go like that, like that, like that. All right. So everything dies. I mean, it works something like like a signature in some sense. I mean, definitely it's more useful than the Ol'Painless with all intents and purposes, because I mean, you know, you can see that it does work pretty well in clearing out stuff just like the signature does in an area kind of way. So if you're looking at cosmic see, there you go, everything dies sort of, right? Just don't forget to reload. Sometimes I forget as well, and then wondering what happened, it's not doing anything right now. But yeah, I mean, I'm not complaining about the whole reload, because I'm a big fan of that reload philosophy. And I think if you have auto-reload, it can't ruin the whole thing. I mean, at least for me, it seems to me that it would be a ruining of the whole thing. So, 1, 2, 3, and then that's it. Fire them all. Right, so that's it. So great, now it's curse, and where's curse? Oh my god, I missed one. Sorry, guys. So sometimes I get too excited. Oh yeah, well, how's my bounty going on? Where have I missed? Oh, the other side, sorry about that. The other side. Okay, just a 1, 2, 3, then after that flamethrower, then I mean, it's effective, right? And well, this environment with the signature is going to be, you know, quite nice. So now is the let me just clear some of these guys first, because you know, sometimes I do regret not clearing some of this nonsense out there. And okay, let's see. Go. Okay, 1, 2, and just aim at curse, reapply DOT, and that's it. Right, so I don't know, is it faster? Is it slower? I mean, what do you guys think? I think it's pretty similar. And anyway, I mean, you know, cosmic terminal these days are not really a good gauge in how fast the hero can kill anyway, I think, because there's a lot of like procs going on. So, but I thought I'd give you some flavor, as in, like, you know, what, how does the tool build pace like, alright? Alright, this is Industrial City Patrol, and Punisher going up against Tombstone. So okay, so this is what I mean, that it's actually quite easy for this sort of environment, whereby you can just like do the your rotation, alright? So it's very nice, because this one you can actually do your rotation, and making sure that the buff is on it. 12 million, do you see that? I don't know what happened, man. So yeah, that's remarkable. I don't know whether you guys got it. I mean, wow, I have to check my video, man. Is it that many or just 12K? Anyway, so yeah, I thought I'd give you a very brief, like, sense of like what Punisher can do in Ol'Painless in Industrial City Patrol if there is something pretty straightforward, like this guy here, alright? So don't stand on bad stuff. Now, but in a situation where, okay, let me just show you a buff here as well. In a situation whereby I have to run around a bit, then, you know, then it becomes a little bit less ideal, right? Because I run out of the buff before the, whoa, hang on a sec. Let me clear some of these guys first. Nuke it. Alright, so that's it. Okay. Alright, welcome back to the training room. And this part of the video is just talk about the Omega system as well as the synergy that I've invested in. And from Omega point of view, as always, my benchmark is 80% cost effectiveness. If you are low in Omega's points, you may go for a 90% cost effectiveness. What am I talking about? There's another video that will help you on the Omega system. So basically, I do not want to put in too much points, you know, because the more you put in, the more expensive it is. Different node behave differently. So there's a way to sort of like help you, guide you how many points you put in. So all in all, I mean, spin tech is something that you should invest in. If you are low in Omega point, you may want to invest. That's just a few here, all right. Then, you know, for any physical hero, this +5 strength is very nice, especially for Punisher, because you need the cost reduction that's from strength. And I picked some of this, like, you know, physical damage base as well as the damage rating just a little bit along the way. You can have it lower a little bit for your if you can't afford that many points to it, all right. Shadow King is something that I really enjoy having for almost all my heroes, and because it buffs not only the crit as well as the brutal, alright? Just a little bit here, just to dump some points here. Nothing fantastic over there. This one is also, I dump the rest of the points here, I don't really need those. And as you know, that for Punisher, strength means cost reduction, and I need the kind of like a cost reduction to it. So I picked this one, but this note is pretty expensive because upfront there's a cost upfront to it, because you get the health as well as the size increase. So do I really need that? I probably not. You know, I may need to rethink, but if I strip this off, then I lose 5% of the cost reduction, right? So that's important. Okay, guild suppression is something that, you know, low hanging fruit. So if you have low in Omega points, something that you can think about on this one. And as well as the rest of it, just skip. Fighting, +9 fighting is great. And also a little bit of brutal damage and health regen, brutal strike, not bad. I mean, if you have points to invest in, these are some of the higher notes that you can consider. So I hope, I mean, Omega system is pretty standard if you watch all my video on which are the notes that you should pick. The red, I try to avoid anything that's proc based, all right? Hero synergy is the usual suspect, cable for crit, you know, Colossus, because there's the physical damage plus health, crit, hot eye for crit damage, and Loki for cost reduction, very important for Punisher. Luke Cage for physical as well, then Moon Knight for physical crit, and Mr. Fantastic for crit damage, 4%, very nice. Yeah, actually, you know what, I should have picked this one instead of Rogue, so, you know, so yeah, I think I'll pick She-Hulk, which is 3% damage rating. That one is better with the health regen. It doesn't really help that much anyway on the health on hit. It feels same thing. Then I have the versus boss for Squirrel Girl and Wolverine on the brutal strike percentage kind of thing. So yeah, that is all it is, and I hope you enjoyed this Punisher video. It has been many hours in the making, and sorry it's a little bit too long, but I really want to cover all grounds because it is very important to explain how the whole reload works, alright? So two builds, Ol'Painless and Flamethrower, I think they're pretty much you know, similar when you go to the field, although when in a control environment, like I mentioned, you know, targets pretty much not attacking you and not moving much like raid, then Ol'Painless is really nice. You only have a few buttons to worry about, the pineapple grenade, the headshot, as well as the blast, buckshot blast, which is your three thing that you play with, and then reload for the signature. All right, so I hope you enjoyed this video. Any question, leave me a note there, and enjoy the rest of the day. Bye.